time for some DIY. Roll the intro. What up guys, welcome back to another episode. My name is Eddie Bear and today I'm going to show you how you can physically modify a regular sized SSD so it becomes small enough that it will fit into a custom sized SSD caddy for the Atomos Ninja V. By the way, I know this project can sound intimidating and complicated, but actually it's way easier than you think. And if you have everything you need, you can complete this DIY project within 10 to 15 minutes. For this purpose, I'm using a WD Blue 500GB SSD and turn it into a custom SSD for the Atomos Ninja V. Now you may be wondering, why not just go with those Angelbird SSDs that perfectly fit into the Atomos Ninja V and do not stand out of the body? Well, an Angelbird SSD with 500GB comes around 200 euros. A WD Blue 500GB SSD, which by the way is a normal consumer SSD, costs you just about 50 bucks. So if you're working on a bigger project, you will have to throw a lot of money on more than one Angelbird SSD, whilst you also could go ahead and buy a bunch of cheap drives, customize them for your needs, and even look cool in front of your customer. And you know, sometimes it's just not about having a rugged drive like the Angelbird drives. Sometimes it's good enough to have cheap drives like the WD Blue 500GB, since this one is even supported by the Atomos, so why not go this way? Now let's talk about the things that you will need to create your own custom SSD caddy. I know there is one component in here that could be quite challenging for some of you out there, because you will need a 3D printer. If you don't own a 3D printer, you also can order prints online. They are pretty cheap by now, and if you don't want to learn anything about 3D printing or don't own a printer, this would be the easiest way to get your print. I'm going to link the SSD caddy files down in the description below, so you can grab them, send them anywhere to get printed, or you print them yourself, and if you want to, you also can modify them, so they are free for everybody. And before you now grab your jigsaw and rip your SSD apart, the first thing you will need to do is to disassemble the SSD to make sure that you're not cutting into the actual SSD electronics. To take the SSD apart, you will need the following things. Obviously, you need an SSD, a Phillips head screwdriver, and also a sharp tweezer.
The first thing we need to do is to expose the screws underneath the big sticker on the back of the SSD. So take your tweezers and start to gently peel off the sticker in the back. You do not need to remove the whole sticker, it's also enough to just remove the parts where there is a screw underneath it, but if you want to, you can of course remove the whole sticker. Once you removed all four screws, you can go ahead and remove the aluminum back of the SSD. To do so, start by lifting up the body on the opposite side of the SATA connector. And big surprise, most of the drive is actually empty, even though this is a 500GB drive. The actual SSD is only secured by two additional screws, so after you remove them, you can lift off the SSD from the plastic bottom. Now reassemble the housing of the SSD and make sure to fasten the two screws that are closest to the SATA connector. This way the housing cannot wiggle around while you're cutting it.
Now it's time to cut down the housing of the SSD to a total length of 7 centimeters, but you also can go shorter if you want to, but 7 centimeters would fill out the whole caddy. So now make a mark where you need to cut, take your jigsaw, or you also can use a hacksaw if you don't own a jigsaw. Since aluminum and plastic are soft materials, you also can do this project by hand.
Take your time while cutting, cause you don't have too much space to hold the SSD, and also watch your fingers so you have 10 of them after the fact. If everything went accordingly, you should end up with a result like this. Now you also know why it's important to remove all the parts of the SSD before cutting, so now take your vacuum cleaner and remove all the shavings and sawdust.
After a thorough cleanup, it's now time to reassemble the SSD.
Reinsert the SSD into the plastic bottom of the SSD housing and tighten down the two screws that came with it, but be gentle so you don't damage the plastic threads. If the heatsink got misaligned in the whole process, remove it with the help of a screwdriver and put it back on flush so your SSD will not get any kind of heat damage. Now put the lid of the SSD back on, install the two screws you removed prior, and make sure to tighten them down carefully so you don't damage the plastic threads. If you did leave on the sticker, you now can seal off the screws with its help. The only thing left to do is to seal off the hole we cut into the SSD. You can use something like hot glue or duct tape, but either way, make sure to seal it so nothing unwanted can make its way into the SSD. Now it's time to assemble your own 3D printed SSD caddy. Insert your SSD into the lid of the SSD caddy and make sure that the SATA connectors are facing the hole in the caddy. And don't worry, the first time assembly can't take some persuasion, so if you face some resistance, don't be afraid to use some gentle force. Once the lid is in position, you can use two additional screws to strengthen the whole setup even further, but this is optional. Even without the screws, the caddy holds up just fine.
And now you're already done. So I've been using this caddy at the moment right here in the Atomos for about half a year. I used it on customer projects. I also used it on the IFA 2019. So it is pretty reliable. It never did fall out once out of the Atomos. It has a perfect fit. And you also look cool in front of your customer because everybody will notice your own logo on the back of the caddy. So this is a cool thing to personalize your equipment even further, and at the same time you're even saving money. So what is your opinion about my custom Atomos Ninja V SSD caddy? Is this a project that you would try to tackle yourself, or are these kinds of tutorials too intimidating? If you have any questions regarding the tools or the materials I used in today's video, let me know down in the comments below. And I hope you got something out of today's video, you learned something new. If you liked it, don't forget to like, share, subscribe. And with that said, thank you for watching, and I see you in the next one. Peace!